today we are back again at Collecticon Studios with another review for you guys. Captain Britain from the Marvel Universe line, and I have a special guest today, Dalen757, finally, after I've been...
What's up, YouTube? I'm finally here. My brother's been twisting my arm for so long, so I figured, hey, why not? Let's just jump right into it.
He's over there.
I'm over here. You can't see me, but you can hear me.
He's right there. But I'm excited about this, so we're going to do the first ever dual brother review as far as...
I don't think that's been done, really. If it has, correct us if we're wrong, but I don't think so.
We've
never done it for sure.
Well, we haven't done it, but at any rate, we are here, and Captain Britain is the guy. He's up here today, and here we have a fellow Brit, Mr. Union Jack. We're going to move him out of there. He was kind of having a conversation with him. An amazing figure. This is actually not mine, guys, so I'm a little... I want to say jealous.
Actually, this figure belongs to me, so sorry, bro.
Yeah, and I'm really jealous about this, but this is an amazing figure, and I said, please, let me review it. Let me touch it just to see what it's like, man. I can't wait till we put him in a detail. But here we are, Union Jack, and look at him. Great figure top to bottom. Now, D, correct me if I'm wrong, but is David still working on these things?
I believe so. I think so. That's why the sculpts are so good. He's definitely one of the lead sculptors. He used to sculpt for the actual 6-inch Marvel Legends, which I wish he was still there. But now he's with the Marvel Universe, so I can't hate because I do collect both. So, hey, if I can't get him in a 6-inch, I'll take him in 3 3/4. So, this sculpt is just flawless to me, in my opinion.
I have to agree. What I'm looking at right here is one of the most amazing figures I've ever seen. And every time you guys look at one of these videos, you probably hear me say that, and I sound like a broken record, but these guys at Marvel and Hasbro on the production line, they are definitely upping the quality. And I can't pick these things apart like I used to in the past. If you see some of my old videos when I was doing the Sky Punch channel, this one here, I mean, look at the paint application.
That paint application is almost flawless. I mean, there's no like off the lines, everything's centered very well. Because how normally you have to go through 2 or 3 different figures to find the right mold. But that one, I think, is pretty flawless.
It is, man. And I'm looking at it, and you know me, I can be quite the stippler.
Yeah, he's very, very critical when it comes to, criticizing and critiquing a figure. So,
matter of fact, when I buy these figures, you'll know I'll have my paintbrushes practically in hand in Walmart.
He knows that he's
ready to touch them up.
Touch them up and fix them how he wants them.
But this one, I mean, like I said, top to bottom. Top to bottom. I mean, look at that.
I have OCD,
Oh, well, it's hereditary in some cases. But here he is, guys. Captain Britain. Look at these flawless lines like Dalen757 said here. I mean, not so much as one paint stroke out of the lines. They captured the standard Union Jack, the British flag. Let me see if I'll allow the camera to focus. Perfectly here on his cowl. Hope I said that right. Batman wears a cowl, right? Cowl?
Yeah.
Yeah, instead of mask.
So.
And even the lines on the side along the jawline are perfect. This figure, man, I thought that the Archangel was my favorite, but I'm going to have to say, even though I don't have this in my detail yet, this one is by far my favorite. Now,
it's a tight figure. I'm still going to go with Archangel.
Really?
And then Juggernaut, then Captain Britain. But that's my opinion. That's what makes us different. You have your opinion, I have mine.
And I'll give you that, but I mean...
Because that Juggernaut is sweet.
But are you looking at what I'm pointing at?
I am looking at it.
All right.
I won't lie, this is beautiful, though.
It looks good.
This is really nice.
It looks good.
But,
Give me some background on this, because I know I was a little confused about this guy. I used to think over the years when... I knew he was with Excalibur and, X-Men.
Right, yeah.
Currently.
In both of them, right.
And then there's like a Union, there's like a British Corps, like
exactly.
The Lantern Corps in DC.
And I bet you I know what you thought. You probably thought he was just the equivalent of like Captain America.
Exactly.
He's a highly athletic guy that can kind of flip, kind of do this. Well, bro, you're wrong.
Kind of like Union Jack here.
Exactly. Let me give you a brief rundown of what he can do and show you what he's all about.
All right.
If you don't know his name is Brian Braddock. He does have a sister who is also an X-Men member. Psylocke is his sister, Betsy. or Elizabeth.
Which I didn't know that. But
I know you knew that one.
But there's another member that I wasn't aware of.
I think his brother's name is Jamie Braddock.
Okay.
Right, yeah, which we don't really know much about that guy or that character. But
now, what are you aware of any of his powers or anything about him?
That I am.
Okay.
I am somewhat clever. All
right.
You didn't get all the brains. You didn't get all of them.
I got some of the art.
Okay, well,
brains.
Just to give a general rundown of his stature.
Okay.
He's 6'6". He's 257 pounds, so he's a pretty solid, healthy guy. Some of his superhuman powers include flight. He can fly up to 770 miles per hour.
Wow, so that's well above the index of a commercial jet, guys.
His superhuman strength, he can lift up to 90 tons.
Wow.
So I think you've been underestimating the just kind of Captain America.
I was way off.
Not also, the suits that he creates.
Now I knew it could fly.
The suits that he creates also help him project force fields that can block physical force and energy force. Did you know that?
No, I didn't. Now wait a minute. Now, so what we're saying is it his suit, like kind of like Iron Man?
Well, his suit enables him to do the physical force fields because he wasn't born with mutant powers like Betsy was.
Right.
He was actually some kind of thing that happened through the land of where he's from or whatnot.
Some mystical,
magical.
So kind of like the Black Knight.
Exactly, absolutely.
What is it with you Brits?
We love you guys.
We love you guys. We love Ryan Wright, sorry.
He has enhanced reflexes, enhanced stamina. So he does have this stuff like Captain America, but far more greater. Because 90 tons, can't lift probably 90 pounds. No, he can't.
No, not even close to 90 tons. So this guy is definitely a heavy hitter in terms of strength.
Can you do a brief rundown of like his power grid, just to give you a scale to 1 to 7?
All right, that's something new.
His intelligence is 5 out of a scale of 1 to 7, which marks him a genius.
So he's up there with Banner and those
exactly.
guys.
Exactly. He's a master physicist, engineer, roboticist, and acrobat. His strength is 6, believe it or not. So Colossus.
Sure, this guy's not German. No,
that's what I'm saying. I don't know, man. His strength is 6, so Colossus would get a run for his money because Colossus can't fly. His durability is 6.
And he has them, and I don't.
And his fighting ability is 4. So this guy's pretty much a handful, basically. He's the leader of Excalibur. And one more thing, his wife is Megan, which is also an Excalibur. His
now,
wife is
that
Megan.
I did yes, not know.
Wife.
See, this is why Dale and 757 guys
I
had
do serve
to join,
a purpose. Not much, but
join Collecticon because he tightens up the things that I can't do. He kind of just brings it full circle.
Which isn't much. I mean, he does all the customs, the designs, and all that. I just
stand there
and look pretty, even though you guys can't see me. But
he is pretty. But anyway, guys, here we are back to the review. We're having fun with this. We're being silly tonight. We're having a good time. I'm excited about us finally teaming up, doing what we're supposed to do. But here we are, Captain Britain, in all of his glory. If you do not have him, go get him.
Buy him. Where do we get him anyway? Where do we find this guy at? Because we went on a couple places, but
Toys R Us.
Exactly.
Close to our house. A secret Toys R Us, and we're not going to talk about that on camera
exactly.
because we don't want you to know, Jarrett.
Jarrett, no.
So, without further ado, guys, we're going to get out of here. We're going to let you take another 360-degree look at the Captain Britain.
And I know we didn't go into all the articulation and stuff, but you guys pretty much know how they work. The arms rotate, head rotates, pops off, waist move, legs bend. Go buy the figure. You know how it goes.
And yeah, you get them in hand, you'll definitely see how this guy behaves. So until next time, keep collecting. Start painting. We're
it's showtime. I chase the wind of the sea.